Colombia no acepta amenazas de ninguna naturaleza y mucho menos del narcotráfico. Los colombianos debemos tener claridad que no estamos ante el nacimiento de una nueva guerrilla, sino frente a las amenazas criminales de una banda de narcoterroristas que cuenta con el albergue y el apoyo de la dictadura de Nicolás Maduro.
Fighting words for a nation that's no stranger to conflict. More than 200,000 people died in the 52-year-long war between the leftist guerrilla group, the Revolutionary Armed Forces of Colombia, known as FARC, and the government. But in recent years, there's been a fragile peace, brokered in a 2016 accord to end the bloodshed. It's now at risk of crumbling. A group of dissident FARC rebels, including a former commander who negotiated the deal, says it's taking up arms again.
It is the continuation of the guerrilla struggle in response to the state's betrayal of the peace agreements in Havana.
He's accused the state of failing to uphold its side of the pact, including protection for demobilized guerrillas. About 7,000 former combatants handed over their weapons and agreed to return to civilian life as part of the deal. The majority of them and FARC's political leadership say they're committed to it. Temporary settlements like this one were set up to help ex-guerrillas reintegrate into society.
There have been many difficulties in this process, but this does not mean that we are going to give up and take up arms again. No, on the contrary, we cannot leave what little we have already built.
The health of the deal under President Iván Duque had already been questioned. He came to power last year on a pledge to change parts of the accord, and had support from Colombians who felt the rebels got off too lightly. He's been accused of moving too slowly to implement parts of the deal. It's full of promises that will take years, if not decades, to deliver, like greater development in rural areas affected by the fighting. So delays already at this point in the process are adding to concerns. And the government is still fighting dissident FARC guerrillas. It's estimated there are more than 2,000 fighters, including recruits who've joined after the accord was signed. Bogotá accuses Venezuela of providing some of them with shelter. This new threat has shaken Colombia's peace. But was it already in danger before this recent call to arms? Natalie Pohonen, The Newsmakers.